गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास सेवेंथ। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी वर स्टडिंग अबाउट थर्मामीटर मेजरिंग टेम्परेचर। नाउ इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू रीड अबाउट क्लिनिकल थर्मामीटर। सो स्टूडेंट्स ओपन पेज नंबर 42 इन योर साइंस बुक एंड कीप अ पेंसिल विथ यू टू अंडरलाइन हार्ड वर्ड्स। Now I'm going to read. A clinical thermometer is used to take the body temperature of a human being. It is also called doctor's thermometer. So clinical thermometers are used to know the body temperature of humans. It is also known as doctor's thermometer. This is hidden part. You look carefully at a clinical thermometer. You will find that the scale on its stem shows temperature. Turn the page. From 35 degrees Celsius to 43 degrees Celsius only. The normal temperature of a healthy human body is 37 degrees Celsius. And it never drops to 35 degrees Celsius or rises to 43 degrees Celsius unless certain drastic conditions are reached. Here students, you have to underline drastic conditions means difficult condition. Okay, I cannot underline these words, but you can. So underline these two words. So we have understood from this paragraph that you must have seen in a doctor's clinic that at the stem of the thermometer marks are only from 35 degrees Celsius to 43 degrees Celsius. The temperature of a normal human body is 37 degrees Celsius. Then the temperature of the thermometer cannot go below 37 degrees Celsius, nor can it go above 43 degrees Celsius until a difficult time comes. Is that clear, students? A clinical thermometer is almost the same as a laboratory thermometer but has a slight bent or kink. Knick. Underline this word knick. Knick means bent, which is given in the capillary tube just above the bulb. To check the body temperature, the thermometer is normally placed in the mouth. So we have seen that a clinical thermometer is the same as a laboratory thermometer, but there is a kink in the capillary just a little above of the bulb of clinical thermometer. To check the body temperature, the thermometer is normally placed in the mouth. The mercury in the bulb expands according to the thermometer in the mouth and its level increases in the capillary tube. We take out the thermometer from the mouth after keeping its bulb in the mouth for about a minute and read the marking on the scale to know our body temperature. Okay, so we understood that to check the body temperature, we place the thermometer under the tongue in the mouth. The mercury inside the thermometer expands as soon as the body temperature is found. After 1 minute, we take out the thermometer from the mouth. As far as the mercury is reached in the thermometer, we read the reading and after that we get to know our body temperature. Now the next paragraph. Why does the temperature in a clinical thermometer not drop when it is taken out of the mouth? Actually, when the thermometer is taken out of the mouth, the mercury in the bulb contracts as temperature outside our body is normally less and the mercury column breaks at the clinic. Thus, the level of mercury remains constant even after taking the thermometer out of the mouth. So, here student, you have to underline contracts. Contracts means sink or decrease in size. So, why does the temperature in a clinical thermometer not drop when it is taken out of the mouth? When the thermometer is taken out of the mouth, mercury contracts because the temperature of outside is less than the temperature in the mouth at that time. But the mercury does not fall from its column or level because of the presence of clinic. Clinic prevents mercury level from falling on its own. Is that clear, students? Now the next paragraph. The mercury in the stem is brought back to the bulb by giving a few soft jerks with your hands before the thermometer is used again. Here you have to underline this word jerks. Jerks means shock or flick. So, mercury returns to its level in the thermometer if we jerk the thermometer several times with our hands before the thermometer is used again. Here, you can read the definition of clinic. Clinic is a sharp twist in something long and narrow. So, clinic is a sharp twist in thermometer because the thermometer is long and narrow. Now the activity 4.2. You have an objective to observe the body temperature of different person. So first you have to make a chart of body temperature of yourself and two members of your family, brother, sister, mother, father or your grandparents. So first you have to make a chart of body temperature of your and any two members of your family. They can be your brother, sister, mother, father or your grandparents. Now measure the temperature at the same time every day and for at least a week. So now you have to measure the temperature at the same time every day to your temperature and to your sibling or parents temperature and for at least a week. Record. So now you have to record the thermometer in the table given below. Here is the table. If you performing this activity, so you can draw this table and you can take temperature from the thermometer of your body and of your sibling or parents' body at least 1 week. Do you find any difference in the body temperature of different persons? The body temperature of every person is not exactly 37 degrees Celsius but may be slightly lower or higher. Actually, the normal temperature 37 degrees Celsius is the average body temperature of a large number of healthy persons. So actually, not all humans have a body temperature of 37 degrees Celsius. This may cause a little bit less or a little bit more. 37 degrees Celsius is a definite range that the temperature of a healthy human can be. So, this is the average body temperature of a large number of healthy persons. Is that clear, students? Now, you can turn the page. following precautions should be taken while checking the temperature of a body with a clinical thermometer. So you can take some precautions while checking the temperature of a body with a clinical thermometer. First, the thermometer should be washed before and after every use, preferably with an antiseptic solution. So you have to wash the thermometer after and every use with an antiseptic solution like Sebelon or Dettol. Now the next, before measuring the temperature, make sure that the mercury level is below 35. You can do it by holding it firmly and giving it a few jerks. So before measuring, you have to make sure that the mercury level is below 35, and for this you can jerk the thermometer several times with your hand. Now keep the thermometer bulb properly under your tongue or arm at least for 1 minute. So you have to keep the thermometer bulb properly under your tongue or arm, or under tongue or arm of any patient at least for 1 minute. Next, to read the temperature, keep the thermometer at eye level. So when you are reading the mercury level in the temperature in the thermometer, to read temperature you should keep the thermometer in the front of your eyes. Now the next, always handle the thermometer carefully. It can break if it hits against some hard object. You all know that thermometer is made up of a glass, so it can break if it falls on a hard object. Is that clear? Now the last, never hold the thermometer by the bulb. So you should never hold the thermometer by the bulb. You should always hold the thermometer from the capillary end of the thermometer. So is that clear, students? In the next class, we will understand about the laboratory thermometer. So that's all, students. Thank you, class.